Hi again, Art the Boards Paint. Today, I found these at Dollar Tree. These are scoops. I cut kind of partially open. They were a dollar, and I'm just now opening this. It comes with two scoops. So I am going to try to do kind of like a ribbon pour with this. I'm going to get my paints ready, and I'll be right back. You won't even miss me. Okay, so I've got my little paint colors picked out. Now these are kind of like colors from my last video. This is a aquamarine or teal or something. Then I have this blue, I think it's a phthalo blue. I have this what they call festive red, which I think is more pink. I've got two cups of white. I've got some lime green. I got some purple. And I got this left over from my multi-ring pour that I just did, so I'm going to throw that in there. I have no idea what that's going to look like. But hey, we'll see. So, I'm going to just use one scoop. I think I'm going to use this bigger one. Excuse me. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to take these all down, and I'm going to put some white down. Get these all down. Okay, and I'm going to pour some white on here. Just to kind of get some motion action going. Okay, I see a hair in here or something. Yep. Actually, I want to get a little bit wet with paint so I can get it up. I think I did it. Okay. So, let's see. I use one of these sticks to spread it. Whatever I have at the time is what I use to spread my paint. Because I'm forever losing track of my stuff. Okay. So, here we go. Be careful because my paints are right in front of my Lazy Susan, and if I turn it the wrong way, these little cups of paint will spill. All right, I'll change that in a second. This does not have to be perfect. I'm just getting some paint down on it. Was I doing? I really don't know what I'm doing sometimes. I just watch a bunch of videos and then I come up with my own, try to come up with my own style or something I can do to make it different. Okay, that's got enough paint down. All right, so here's my scoop, and I think I usually see this is they put, what in the world? Oh, it's sitting on some dry paint or something. Okay, I was like, why has it got paint on it already? Okay, clean scoop. So I'm gonna put my white down. Okay, it's my base. All right. So ribbon pour, I think should go this way. And I'm just gonna go random here. I don't even know what colors I'm using. Just using them as I pick them up. Purple, that lime green. See this good. Okay. I get some dark blue. Okay, and some of this pink, red, festive red. I never call them the right colors. And I got a little bit of purple I can still put on here. I don't want to overdo it, so let me put some of this mix on here from my last pour, just on the side there. I think I've used all the colors, and I don't know if I'm going to do good on this, but how you're supposed to do is just let it come out just like it is on the scoop. I'm going to switch it up a little bit by turning it. Turn it some more. That kind of, as a scoop gets less on it, it comes out a lot slower, so I'm going a lot slower now, so I can make sure I get a good flow here of paint. So that's looking pretty cool. Okay, so I think I want to do another one and go a different direction or something. So I'm going to mess this up and I'm going to put more white down on here. Okay, and we're going to just start again. Guys, I don't know. I don't know. I just do it. Everything in painting is fair game. It's all fun. It's all for fun. It all gives its own beauty. Or not. Sometimes it looks terrible. But then you just start over. Okay, what else? What other color? Oh, a lime green. Okay, and where's that leftover? Okay, I got that leftover. I think it's this one. No, it ain't this one. It's this one. Alright. So I want to do another one. Let's see. I'm going to turn this around. Get this out of the way because it's hitting it. Get this out of the way. Okay, now we're good. So I'm thinking maybe I could finish this. It's got different colors though on it this time. Well, they're pretty much the same. Whatever, right? Let's just go. Let's just go. See what happens. Oh, that's really pretty. Really is, guys. Wow, I like it. I think that one turned out better than this first attempt here. Maybe I know what I'm doing this time. I don't know. Nah, I never know what I'm doing. That is very cool. Alright, so I still have some paint, so I'm going to do it one more time. And I'm out of white on this cup, so this is again a 10x10. That seems to be my what I have right now in stock, so I'll try to do it the same way, but I can't remember how I do it, so it'll be pretty much the same way. Alright, and then my lime green. Let me get up here. Okay. And then this leftover mix-match dirty pour. Okay. So this is really cool. Okay, I'm going to start from here again, since it's kind of faded, and just kind of go with that. This is probably going to be, I just spilled my cup of paint. It's probably going to be the last of what I'm going to do. I don't have any silicone in this, it's just Floetrol and paint. Okay. And I'm just gonna go zigzag here, maybe. Yeah, that looks kind of cool. Zigzag over here. That's cool. And that looks like it's got texture, although I know it's not gonna dry like that. But that looks pretty cool anyway. I wanna try to use all the paint that I have in here, so. I mean, I know white white space is good. But it does, it's got white in there, so I'm not too worried about it. Alright, come on, pink. It's like waiting for ketchup. Come out of that bottle. Okay. Well, it's pretty good. I'm happy. So, let me let you feast your eyes on this baby. It looks pretty cool, huh? I'm going to give it some tilting, just enough to blend the colors a little bit. I'm going to stand up for this. I think standing up always works better for this. Okay. Go this way. I don't like the way that was forming. Okay, this is pretty cool. This looks like a Christmas tree to me. I don't know. I'm probably gonna mess it up now. Because this has not got enough paint down here. But that's okay. I'm not making a Christmas tree anyways. I'm just making some abstract art. That's pretty cool. Yeah, it has, this has some white on here, but it's also got canvas, so I'm probably going to have to touch that up. I don't know. Because I don't really want to lose the composition I got going here. Okay. You know, I think I really have fallen in love with this lime green. And I've always loved teal and all that, and I don't like the way that's looking. So I am gonna throw down some more paint right here. Yep. Just kind of get this edge that does not have enough paint. And then just kind of jiggle it, wiggle it, move it around. So it'll all flow and look natural instead of thrown on, you know. Yeah, looks pretty good. I don't know if you can see that, but that doesn't look too bad now that I spread it around. Try to get my edges. Turn it, get my edges again. Nice! Almost, guys. That would have been a terrible, terrible catastrophe. Okay. I'm not liking this now. What the heck? What the world happened here? I don't know. It looks like it got stretched out. See, I don't know what to do about that. Let's see. I'm going to put a little paint on it. Hopefully not mess it up, but hope I'm not messing it up too much. But that's a cool ribbon just by itself, that one that I just made. That's pretty cool. That's better. I'm going to go in a little bit this way. That definitely gives it a different look there. Because it's going a completely different direction than the rest of it. But now it's kind of looking more cohesive, I think. You guys, I'm just starting out with this. I've been doing it for about a year now, but I'm trying to grow my channel, and I'm not I'm not good at it because I don't have time. I don't have a lot of time to spend. But I really like to learn. If you guys got any tips or tricks for me on how to do better videos, how to spread the word about my YouTube channel, I can really use the help. And this is Canvas showing right here, so I'm fixing that. Whoop. Okay. Anyway, I think this turned out pretty cool. I'm liking it. Again, I'm going to give you a close-up, because I don't know if you could see all of it in the camera. It's pretty cool. Had a lot of color. A lot of interest. A lot of... I'm getting paint all over my arm. That's okay. Alright. So let me clean up myself a little bit. I have learned to roll out some paper towels for myself when I do this, because I do get messy. I do tend to get messy. Okay, so there you have it. Another pour using a scoop. That came out pretty handy. This is what the scoop looks like now. I just washed that off and it could be reused. And I'm going to go ahead and torch this. You guys, I got to tell you, I've had so much bad luck with torches. I finally got one at Harbor Freight a couple weeks ago. I just found my propane today, because that's the way my life is. And so it's pretty cool. It was like, I think, $10. It has a safety on it. I have to put the safety down every time, which is... I don't understand why they have it built like that, but it works good once you get it. Once you get that dang safety. Oh my goodness. It's like pulling a trigger. There we go. So now I'm going to torch it. My last video, I did a multi-ring pour, but I did torch it. I just did it off camera. That's it. I'm not going to over-torch it. I think a lot of artists tend to over-torch, and they torch before they pour, they torch after they pour, sometimes they torch during their pour. I just don't think it needs that much torching. That's just my opinion. So now I'm getting a little bit of lacing here. Let's see if I could show you. I'm getting some there. And I'm getting some over here on the red. So that's pretty cool. Anyway, that's my pour for today. I'm sure I'm going to be coming up with something again here pretty quick. But I don't want to make my video too long. So have a good morning, good day, good evening, good week. And happy holidays. And I'll talk to y'all later. Bye-bye now.